Belinda Audiobooks presents this unabridged recording of Aussie Bites, Holly and the Dream Fixer by Rosemary Hayes and read by Stig Wemyss. Be sure to check us out on the web at www.belinda.com. Holly and the Dream Fixer. Holly dreams of a life as a princess on a tropical island. Then, pow! Suddenly, Xavier appears, a wish-fulfilment agent to make it all come true. But life as a tropical princess may not be exactly what Holly imagines, and she's in for a few surprises. Holly and the Dream Fixer by Rosemary Hayes. The dedication reads, for George, Thomas and Emily. Chapter 1. It was Saturday and Holly Harris and her mum and dad were in the kitchen. Mr. Harris was reading the paper and Mrs. Harris was on the phone booking their summer holiday. Holly Harris sat and scowled. It's not fair, she muttered. Her parents said nothing. It's not fair, she repeated. Her father sighed. Her mother put the phone down and came back to the table. All fixed, she said. Same caravan park as last year. Holly scraped back her chair and stood up. Her face was red. It's not fair, she said again. All my friends go on really brilliant holidays and we have to go to that smelly old caravan park again. Why can't we go somewhere exotic for a change? Holly, you know we can't afford... That's what you always say. I'm sick of it. I'm the only one in the whole school who goes to a rotten caravan park. How do you think I feel when they tell me about their fantastic holidays? Surely not all of them, dear, said Mrs. Harris mildly. Holly took no notice. And what about when we have to write about our summer holidays? I ran out of things to say about the caravan park years ago. Mrs. Harris looked across at Mr. Harris. He was trying to look serious. Holly ran out of the room, down the passage and opened the front door. Then she slammed the door behind her as hard as she could. I'm running away and I'm not coming back, she shouted at the door. She stamped her foot. Ever! She stuck out her tongue at the house. Why can't I have an interesting family? She muttered as she ran down the street. Why are they so boring? I bet I'm not really Holly Harris. I bet they took the wrong baby home when I was born. I bet I'm really a princess and my parents are the rich king and queen of a beautiful tropical island. She could just imagine it. The sand, the surf, the palm trees. One day, a rich prince from a nearby island will marry me and give me wonderful presents. I'll do whatever I like. I'll have servants and fabulous food, and I'll never have to have another maths lesson in my entire life. Holly's nose was running. She stopped and dug in the pocket of her jeans for a tissue. She couldn't find one, so she sniffed loudly and wiped her nose on the back of her hand. Then she put her hand in her pocket and felt a couple of coins. Brilliant! There was a supermarket just around the corner, and she walked inside. Holly wandered between the rows. She wanted as many sweets as possible for the money. At last she found a big packet of mini chocolate bars. It cost exactly what she had in her hand. She paid for the sweets and went outside. She sat down on a wall, ripped the bag open with her teeth, and spat out the bit of plastic. She
counted. We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.